हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ अभिषेक शर्मा, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग, SLBS इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज. हेयर आई एम टू डिस्क्राइब अ टॉपिक, गियर ट्रेन, विच इज़ अ टॉपिक ऑफ थ्योरी ऑफ मशीन्स. हेयर वी विल डिस्कस गियर ट्रेन. व्हाट इज़ द गियर ट्रेन मीन्स, टाइप्स ऑफ गियर ट्रेन, एंड वी विल डिस्कस टू टाइप्स ऑफ गियर ट्रेन, सिंपल गियर ट्रेन एंड कंपाउंड गियर ट्रेन. This slide will cover all these things in this video. Okay, let me first tell you what is the gear train. As you all know, I will go for the simple meaning of what is the train. You know, train is a combination of many bogies and driven by the engine. The same thing if happen in the gears, that is known as the gear trains. The many bogies are there, and the engine who is pulling all these bogies, same thing will be happen in a gear train. There will be a driver gear connecting with another gears and driving all these gears to transfer the necessary motion from one point to the other point, or I will say from the driver shaft to the driven shaft. I think it's clear what is the gear train means. Gear train means the transfer of the motion from one end to another end, or from one gear to the another gear, the driver gear to driven gear. Motion of transfer from driver gear to driven gear. For this purpose, we use many kind of gear trains. There are simple gear train, compound gear train, reverted gear train, and epicyclic gear train, compound epicyclic gear train. We will discuss all the these gear trains one by one in this next in with this video and the further videos. So first thing, gear that will used for on the driver shaft is known as driver gear. Means where the power source is there, actually the motion which we are planning to transfer from one point to another point will initiate at that same point or at the same shaft that is known as driver shaft, and the gear that mounted on that shaft is known as the driver gear. And this is the same like the engine of the train who will run all the remaining gears, and that is known as driver gear. The gears which are connected to driver gear but not the actual driven gears are known as intermediate gears. These are known as intermediate gears. I think it is also clear for you. The gears which are connected to the driver gear but not the driven gear, the not the final point where we have are planning to transfer the motion, then the gear which are connected between these driver and driven gear are known as intermediate gears. Okay, this is I think you all will get what is the gear train. When two or more gears are made to mess in each other to transmit power from one shaft to another shaft, or such combination of gears are called gear train or toothed wheels. I think you got the point. We are what the definition is saying, transfer of motion from one point to another point or from one shaft to another shaft using various gears is known as gear train. Okay, what is the nature of train? Let me discuss it. According to velocity required, the velocity ratio, according to we did decide the nature of train according to the velocity ratio and according to the position of shafts, the relative position of the axis of shafts, that is also a parameter to define the nature of these trains. One another parameter is the type of gear we are using. The gear train may consist a spur gear or bevel gear. Also we know spur gear in which the teeth are in teeth interacts on same axis, while in bevel gear the teeth interacts on an सेकेंड, इन केस ऑफ बेवल गियर बोथ शाफ्ट ऑफ आर ऑन परपेंडिकुलर पोजिशंस फॉर द बेवल गियर एंड फॉर द स्पर गियर वी नो द एक्सिस इज द सेम एक्सिस. ओके दैट वी विल डिस्कस इन अनदर चैप्टर वेयर वी विल डिस्कस द गियर्स. नाउ वी हैव टू डिस्कस टाइप्स ऑफ गियर ट्रेंस. देर आर फोर टाइप्स एज आई हैव टोल्ड यू ऑलरेडी. दीज आर सिंपल गियर ट्रेन, कंपाउंड गियर ट्रेन, रिवर्टेड गियर ट्रेन एंड एपिसाइक्लिक गियर ट्रेन. देर इज ऑल्सो वन टाइप ऑफ एपिसाइक्लिक गियर ट्रेन दैट इज ऑल्सो नॉन एज कंपाउंड एपिसाइक्लिक गियर ट्रेन एंड ऑल्सो नॉन एज सन एंड प्लेनेट गियर ट्रेन दैट इज यूज एज ऑल्सो अ गियर ट्रेन. ओके फर्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस द सिंपल गियर ट्रेन. वॉट इज द सिंपल गियर ट्रेन? दिस इज द सिंपलेस्ट फॉर्म ऑफ the gear train in which we will discuss. There the gears are mounted on the shafts, means on each shaft there is only a one gear. First thing that we have to note, on the each shaft we have only the one gear. As shown in the diagram, there are a driver gear on the driver shaft and the follower or driven gear on the driven shaft. Sometimes there will be more gears between them known as intermediate gears. I have already told the thing. We have to count speed ratio and train value for the simple gear train. Next thing is we have to calculate speed ratio and train value for the gear train. Speed ratio is the ratio of, if we go for the definition, what is the speed ratio? Speed ratio is the ratio of speed of driver gear upon speed of driven gear. That is known as the speed ratio. Speed of the driver gear to the speed of driven gear, as we have already discussed in the gears. Yeah, you guys have already known it very well. In the case of the gear, when two gears are in mass, the ratio of their speed will be proportionally equal to the ratio of number of teeth. So there the driver gear to the driven gear ratio is shown by N1 by N2, that is equal to T2 by T1. That is known as, what is this value is equal to? Speed ratio. This value is equal to speed ratio. The next thing we have to calculate the train value. Train value is inverted to the speed ratio. It is known as the driven speed upon driver speed. It is known as driven speed upon driver speed, speed of driven upon speed of driver. So the value will be T1 by T2 because it is N2 by N1. We will know that speed is inversely proportional to the number of teeth in case of gears. Okay, next we will go for the simple gear train having more than one intermediate gear in it. Okay, so there are three gears you can see. First is the driver gear and the third is the driven or follower gear. The gear which is just used to transfer the motion from one point to another point, that will that is known as intermediate gear. I already tell you. So the intermediate gear are used when the distance between both driver and driven shaft is, there are a distance between both driver and driven gear. The shafts are not so close that the individual gears can transfer the motion. In that case, we use the intermediate gears. So here we have three gears in the picture. So what will be the speed ratio? So first we will calculate the speed between 1 and 2. That will be N1 by N2, that is equal to T1 by T2. For the combination 2 and 3, N2 by N3, that will be equal to T2 by T3. I am calculating the speed ratio. So what is the actual driver speed N1 and the final driven N3? So the speed ratio, that will be N1 by N3, that is equal to, I can write this in this form, N1 into n2 upon n3. We have the values for these individuals, so we can put these values and we can find n1 by n3, that is equal to t1 by t2 into t2 by t3. So the final value will be t1 by t3. The same thing we are discussing as follows. So here is the speed ratio for the simple gear train: speed of driver upon speed of driven, number of teeth on driver upon number of teeth on driver. So, and for the train value, the value will be reciprocal, as I already told you. So here further we will go. So we have to know the direction, that also depends on number of intermediate gears. In which direction the driver will run, it depends on the number of intermediate gear. If the number of intermediate gears are even number, I mean to say 2, 4, 6, 8, then the direction of the driver and driven will be in opposite direction. What's my point? When the intermediate gears are, I am not telling you the number, total number of gears, that also even. So intermediate gears, if intermediate gears are more than re1, 2 4 6 8, then the direction the driver and driven will be opposite. On the other hand, if it is an odd number of intermediate gears are there, so then the direction of driven will be in the same direction of the driver. Okay, so these gears are work as the ideal. So these are also known as ideal gear or intermediate gears. What are the purpose of these gears? Here we have two points. First, to connect the gears for the last center distance, and the next, to change the direction in the desired direction we actually want. If we want the same direction, then we will connect the odd number of intermediate gears. If on opposite direction, we can connect even number of the gears. Next is the compound gear train. So what is the compound gear train?